In this example, we're given a quadratic function in general form. We want to write the equation in standard form. The benefit of standard form, or the form we see here, is that we can easily identify the vertex and the equation of the axis. The vertex has coordinates hk, where h is here and k is here, and the equation of the axis of symmetry is x equals h. It's also true if a is positive, the parabola opens up, and if a is negative, the parabola opens down. So the main thing to recognize here is that if we want to put this equation in this form, we have this quantity here, x minus h squared, so we'll have to create a perfect square trinomial. So to start this process, we're going to isolate the x squared term and the x term. So we're going to have y equals 3x squared minus 12x. Now because we want to create a perfect square trinomial, we're going to have to add a constant here. So we'll leave space for that, and then we'll have plus 11, and then whatever constant we add here, we'll have to subtract here to maintain equality. But before we create a perfect square trinomial, we do want to have a leading coefficient of 1 here. So what we're going to do is factor a 3, but we'll factor a 3 only out of the first two terms. So we'll have y equals 3 times the quantity x squared minus 4x. We'll still have plus some constant, and then we'll have plus 11 minus a constant. Now remember, to make this a perfect square trinomial, we'll take half of b and square it, where b is the coefficient of the x term. Again, we take half of b, or divide b by 2, and then square it to make this a perfect square trinomial. So in this case, since b is negative 4, negative 4 divided by 2 is negative 2 squared, which would be positive 4. So we're going to add 4 here, and here's where we have to be careful. If we add 4 here, because of this 3 out here, we're actually adding 12. Remember, if we distribute this 3, 3 times 4 is equal to 12. So to undo adding 12, we actually have to subtract 12 here. So if we have a constant out here, we need to make sure that we distribute so that we know what to subtract. Okay, so now we'll factor this trinomial and then combine our terms here. So we'll have y equals 3. We'll go ahead and factor this into two binomials to begin with. And then plus 11 minus 12 is going to be minus 1. So the factors of x squared would be x and x. The factors of positive 4 that add to negative 4 would be negative 2 and negative 2. So we have minus 2 here and minus 2 here. Notice how we do have a perfect square trinomial here. So we finally have the standard form of the equation. It would be 3 times the quantity x minus 2 squared minus 1. And now in this form, we can recognize first that since a is equal to 3, the parabola opens up. We can also identify the coordinates of the vertex, but we do need to be careful about the signs of the coordinates. Here we have the quantity x minus 2 squared, so the x coordinate is positive 2. And then we have minus 1 here on the end, so the y coordinate is negative 1. And if this is our vertex, we know the equation of the axis must be x equals 2. So let's go ahead and sketch the equation of the axis, which is the vertical line x equals 2, or this vertical line here. We know the vertex is on the axis and it has coordinates 2, negative 1, which should be this point here. Now we know the parabola opens up, but we should find at least two more points to make a more accurate sketch. So let's evaluate the function at, let's say, x equals 3. F of 3 would be equal to 3 times the quantity 3 minus 2 squared. Well, 3 minus 2 is 1, so we have 1 squared minus 1. Well, 1 squared is 1 times 3 is 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. So if f of 3 is equal to 2, we know that the parabola must contain the point with an x coordinate of 3 and a y coordinate of 2, which would be this point here. Notice how this point is 1 unit to the right of the axis of symmetry, so there must also be one point one unit to the left of the axis of symmetry, which would be this point here. And then if we did want to find the y-intercept, we would have to set x equal to 0 and solve for y. Looking at the original form of the equation, if x was 0, this would be 0, this would be 0, and y would be equal to positive 11. So the y-intercept is the point 0, comma 11, but of course that would be off our screen. So we can see this parabola is very narrow, or has been stretched vertically by a factor of 3. So the graph of the parabola is going to look something like this. And of course we can verify this by graphing this on software, which I've done here. And this graph does match the graph that we did by hand. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.